Hello, welcome to another filament testing video. Ethan sent me there two new filaments. These are EABS-GF and EABS-HT. Let's start with the GF. It means glass fiber reinforced ABS. According to the specifications, excellent epoch resistance and toughness. And also I can see chemical corrosion resistance. Now, it would be good to have a little bit more information about this, because as far as I know, the nylon and PETG are more chemical resistant materials. Maybe they compare to some other ABS brands, I'm not sure, but I'm only a mechanical engineer, not chemical engineer, so I'm not going deeply into this kind of discussion. Other information: excellent printability and high speed printing. And usually I experience that these fibers, glass fibers or carbon fibers, not always help with the strength of the material, but in most cases what is more important that it helps with the printability, especially with ABS polycarbonate nylon. The printing is more stable and less warping. Now about HT, probably it means high temperature or something like that. According to specifications, better temperature resistance and heat dissolution temperature up to 100 degrees Celsius. So the temperature test will be very important for these two materials to compare them. Good toughness and impact resistance, so this is similar like with the previous one, and good wear resistance, so this is something I can test, and I will compare exactly these two materials to see if the HT is really more wear resistant compared to the GF. As always, I will repeat my regular mechanical testing with these filaments, and the results are comparable with those which I did in earlier videos. You can download the Excel file from my techfan.com website, but also for my Patreon supporters, this is the only gift to them. I will add these two lines to that summary table, so they can very easily compare these results to those two from previous videos. Let's see what's in the box. They both arrived on this cardboard spool in a natural color, this means without coloring pigments, and I can see only the print settings for the GF between 240 and 270 degrees Celsius, and on the HT it's a little bit lower, between 240 and 260 degrees Celsius. Currently it is not mentioned on their website, but for the glass fiber filaments, usually it is recommended to use some kind of hardened steel nozzle. But according to my contact at the ESAN, the 0.4mm nozzle is enough, we don't need 0.6mm. For HD filament, it is recommended to use a little bit lower speeds because we may have some problems with overhangs, but with both filaments it is recommended to use some kind of enclosure because it will reduce the warping. Let's start with printing with ABS, and I will print everything on BambuLab X1 Carbon. And I'm setting here the generic ABS profile, and then I will do fine tuning in the slicer. Pay attention that the end of the filament is inside the holes. We will compare later with the glass fiber version, and I will explain you why is the difference. I'm using the engineering plate with some glue stick on it. Let's check the different settings in the slicer. The print temperature is 270 degrees Celsius. The max flow rate I calculated from recommended speed, which should be 8, but I tried with the bigger value. Not a perfect start, maybe it really don't like too big speeds, because instead of 8 I set 10 cubic millimeters per second max flow rate. But that's only the brim for that layered adhesion test object, we will see at the end. Most of the test objects is printed except those vertical for the layered adhesion test, but I can see quite a lot of warping on some test objects, so it looks like I have to slow down a little bit more and reprint some test objects. Okay, let's see the first attempt. Two objects has to be reprinted, this one for the temperature test, the most important for this material, and this one for the bending test. Others are perfectly straight, interesting. The adhesion is acceptable, so I have to slow it down definitely. And this time looks like without problems, the brim was added and I reduced the flow rate to 8 cubic millimeters per second. I didn't want to change the print temperature. It is finished correctly. Not the easiest material for the printing, but now I am moving to the glass fiber version, which is probably much easier for printing, and I can do it even on the higher speeds. I will calculate the maximum flow rate from the recommended max speed. Just in case, these are marked with letter H. And this is glass fiber, it is in the same color. And as you can see, the end of the filament is glued. They didn't use these holes, and usually they do this with very brittle filaments, so let's see how brittle is this material. Let's try the bending of the filament. Brittle but acceptable, it will not break inside the Teflon tube. And now let's calculate that flow rate. From recommended max speed, the flow rate is 24, but I reduce it to 18 just in case I want the filament being melted. The movement is much faster, but the printing is nicer. Even this torque test object, the bridging is very nice too. And this is the top view. And the finish of the printing is perfect too. Look at this beauty. I hope the mechanical properties will not be very different, because I really like the printability of the glass fiber version. And they are ready for the mechanical testing. The tensile air pulling test. These test objects are printed in horizontal position. And I'm starting with HT. This is the glass fiber version. Higher brake load. Interesting, different brake type on the HT version. But now let's check the layer adhesion. And again, I'm starting with HT. Different values, but actually because they break on different location. Glass fiber version. Above 30 kilograms, this is very good for the ABS, especially with glass fiber version. And here you can see that the HT broke on different location. And now the shear stress. Side by side HF and glass fiber version. Very equal values here. And they were shared correctly on two cross-section areas. Only one part is missing, I couldn't find it. And now the torque or twist test. I'm starting with HT version. I'm measuring the torque at 90 degree angle. And the GF broke quite early, so it is more rigid. And here you can see how they look like after this test. 3-point bending test. Here you can see when all loads are placed, but I place them one by one. And I'm measuring the deformation after 1, 30 and 60 seconds. Here you can see when the 2.5 load is placed on them. 5 kilograms. And this is under 10 kilograms. And after this test, I can see some permanent deformation on HT version. Glass fiber is completely straight. The creep test, the deformation under the constant load. This is HT, this is glass fiber version, and the load will be 1.25 kilograms. Initial deformation 16.19, and the glass fiber version 14.89. Some more deformation on the HT version. And after 5 days, on HT 17.31 and on glass fiber 15.42 millimeters. Removing of the load and more permanent deformation on HT version. And now temperature testing the oven. So these are those two filaments, HT and glass fiber. And I have several tests in the progress. So these are some IGUS and PETG and ASA filaments. This is M10 nut as a small load, and I will record the temperature of the first deformation. The temperature I will follow with this cooking thermometer. This is a speed up video, and I analyzed the footage frame by frame. The GF, the glass fiber version, started to deform earlier, but it slowed down with the deformation, and the HT deformed faster. I will stop the experiment on 150 degrees Celsius. And now let's take a closer look. For the first filling, the HT is a little bit softer. And only after 1 minute I can even touch them, and for the filling now they are both very equal. For the ABS, the shrinking value is very important, not only because we have less warping, but the dimensional accuracy is important for mechanical parts. Let's measure the HT version, 7962. And the glass fiber version, 7988. Significant less shrinking on the glass fiber version. On their website they claim that the HT is more resistant material. Well, I have great equipment to test this. And I'm starting with HT, but here you can see side by side on the left side the HT, on the right side the glass fiber version. The repeat is 3000 times. And visually or for the feeling, the difference is extremely minimal. And actually, if I measure the depth of the groove, I can see that, yes, the HT just slightly more resistant. And now the ISOD impact test with this half kilogram hammer and these notch test objects to see which material is more brittle or tough. And I already mentioned that my unit is not so good for the tough materials because the hammer have quite a lot of friction if it doesn't break immediately. I ordered an industrial impact testing machine, but I'm not sure when will it arrive. Until that, we will use these informations, but it is mostly good for comparison with, between these two materials or between those materials which I tested in earlier videos.
HT. Glass fiber. Zero position.
As you can see, after this test, they are still connected on these points.
This is the zero position of the hammer, and this is the position after breaking HT and glass fiber filaments. Now, properly the difference is not so big because of that friction I mentioned, but definitely the glass fiber is unfortunately more brittle material compared to the high temperature version. Well, it's time to analyze the data, and this Excel table you can download from mytechfan.com website. And as always, I'm adding these two lines to that summary table for my Patreon supporters. From this video, I'm starting using this symbol, so immediately you can see which material is better. Let's start with the creep test, and here you can see the directly measured values, distance between two reference surfaces, and even here we can see less deformation on glass fiber version. But what we need is a difference between 2 days, and that's what we can see on this graph. And we can see that on day 2, the glass fiber completely stopped with the creeping until the HT version, it stopped with the creeping or reduced on day 3. On tensile test with horizontally printed objects, the glass fiber version was stronger. And on the layer adhesion test, the glass fiber version was again stronger, but with the HT, one test object broke on different cross section, but even then probably it would be weaker compared to the glass fiber version, which is good. It is very rare with these fiber reinforced filaments. On the shear stress, very similar values. On the bending test, well, here we can see the deformation after 30 seconds under these loads, but maybe this is more interesting, where we can see the deformation after 1, 30 and 60 seconds under these loads. And here we can see that smaller values are of course better, and also when it is closer to the horizontal value, it has less creeping, so definitely the glass fiber version is much better in this test. On a torque or twist test, well, the glass fiber version was stronger under the 90 degree angle, the load was bigger, but it was very brittle and approximately after 0.3 rotations, it broke. On the impact test, well, here we can see significant difference. The HT version is much stronger compared to the glass fiber version, which is, thanks to these fibers, brittle material. On the temperature test, well, you saw the results, the HT is a little bit better, so it started with a deformation on a little bit higher temperature, but the glass fiber slowed down with the deformation, and for the feeling I would say that the glass fiber would be better in this test actually. And for the end of shrinking test, and here the glass fiber version is better, less shrinking, this means less warping and better dimensional accuracy.
And just quick conclusions for the end. If I have to compare directly these two materials, almost from any aspect the glass fiber is better. The only advantage I can see with the HT filament is that impact test, so it is tougher material compared to the glass fiber. So if you need this kind of resistance in your application, in that case the HT is better. What I am happy about that the glass fiber has great layer adhesion too, because this is very common that this is the weak point for these fiber reinforced filaments. But here, this is not the weak point, so I am very happy about this. And thanks to the orientation of the fibers, usually it resists good to the bending. This is my experience with these two materials. If you have some other experience, feel free to write me some comments down in the comment section. Thank you for watching and happy printing!